5 years ago you created Paramore. At this time you were at school. At this time, would you imagine you're going to be like famous like this?
Huh.
What was in your brain when you created the band?
I think when we started it was kind of, I mean, you always sort of hope that you'll be able to play music forever and you'll be successful and, you know, you dream, definitely, but it's hard to imagine that, you know, it'll work. So, back then it was just kind of like after school we would all get together and play music and we loved it. We actually liked practicing, I think, more than we did playing out because we didn't really play out a whole lot. We just would hang out at Jeremy's and play music all night just in his living room. So it was just something we did for fun and we loved it.
You said you were in weird school. That made me curious. What was that school?
It was like most of us were in... It was not really, it wasn't so much a private school, but it was like a homeschool tutorial. So you would go once a week and you would get your
it's
lessons.
Pretty cool.
Oh yeah, it was amazing.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. That's probably why I'm a little bit crazy. I don't know. I guess it was really cool because a lot of the kids there were into music and were, you know, kind of, I think, more creative than, like, you know, none of us really loved school. It was just kind of a hangout, so.
Yeah. And at the same, who found the name Paramore and why? You remember?
Well, we got our friend's mom, her maiden name was Paramore. We thought it sounded really cool. we were just like, that sounds awesome. But, you know, we, like, the name was around for a while, and we finally committed to it, and it was because we were all kind of looking up different names and seeing what they meant, and we looked up Paramore. And there's a Spanish translation, there's a French translation, but, like, we liked that it meant, you know, for love, and we liked that it meant secret lover, and, you know, it just had a lot of cool definitions, and most of them, you know, all of them had to do with love, so that was cool.
Okay. Your previous album, Riot, was a big success. Mm-hmm. And before talking about the new one, mm-hmm. we're going to listen a song in about Riot.
Oh,
which
okay.
one will you choose?
Which song?
Of Riot?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Riot. What's your favorite of Riot, team?
Let the Flames Begin.
Mm. That's a good choice.
Right.
Yep. Well, that's probably one of our favorite songs to play live as a band. It's just got a lot of energy. And we changed it a lot. You know, it sounds a lot different on the record. But, yes, it's kind of, you know, I kind of like our darker songs. I tend to like a little bit more. And so that one was kind of on the darker side of Riot. And, so it's just kind of high energy, and it reminds me a little bit of our live show. So,
yeah.
Let the Flames Begin.
So listen to it. You're going to listen to it. I'm going to play it and stuff.
Sweet.
Now is the present part. So you're back with the third album since September. You bring I. My English is not too bad. How do you feel with this new baby? Is everything okay? Like, how did you work on it?
Brand New Eyes was like... When we started writing it, it was definitely a weird situation because we hadn't written songs together in a while, and we'd been through, like, you know, some kind of crazy times on the road that weren't necessarily the best. It was kind of, you know, we went through some rough times. So next thing we knew, we were in a studio, like, cramped in this room together, and we were expected to write a record. And I think we were all really nervous, and we all wanted it to be awesome. We didn't know how to do it, you know, kind of forgot. So I ended up realizing that I had a lot to say. And when one day at the studio, we were kind of like, we couldn't come up with anything. And Josh started playing this riff, like, probably 10 minutes before we were ready to, like, leave, because we were kind of giving up. And he started playing this riff, and we were all like, what's that? That's awesome. And it ended up being Ignorance. And I took it home and I wrote lyrics that day, and they all sort of had to do with our band and, like, kind of the negative things that we had been through and how I felt about it. And that just opened up the whole story, and it kind of got us to talking. So all the songs are really, really, like, personal, like, in a way that is far more personal than any of the other records, because it's all having to do with the five of us. So it is definitely our baby. It's hard to pick one song over another, because they all are so special. And live, they really come to life, and I think our fans, you know, like, it's so awesome to hear them sing all of it, because it just, they mean so much.
Yeah, and you were really busy, because at this time you were also working on the Twilight project.
Yes.
So this is a amazing story. Can you say it again for the Goomers you are listening to?
Yeah.
Like, you were reading the book?
Yeah, I was reading, I was given Twilight, the first book, so I took it on the road with us, actually while we were over here in Europe. And at the same time that I was reading, we had sort of started writing again, just randomly, and Josh and Taylor were working on a song that was really dark, and I loved it. I just kind of became attached to it really quickly. So I started writing, and then I realized that the story, you know, the Twilight story, kind of, it seemed similar, like some of the feelings expressed in the book. I felt like the song kind of had a lot to do with, so I heard they were making a movie, and then I heard the soundtrack was going to happen, and I was like, guys, we got to get on the soundtrack, like, this would be so cool, and it's a vampire, like, love story, and the guys were like, okay, cool. So we recorded at soundcheck just while we were practicing for the show. We recorded like a demo version of Decode, and then a demo version of Caught Myself, and we sent them both in, and we pretty much begged our way onto the soundtrack, because we really wanted to be a part. Like, we'd never done a movie before, so it worked, luckily.
It was a good one.
Yeah, I
good choice.
We were
really good one.
We had no idea it was gonna be that popular.
It's amazing, bravo. Now you're like a big famous band. Can you tell us what's your lifestyle? You are traveling all the time. It's amazing. It makes me dream actually.
Yeah, it's amazing. Traveling around is a lot of fun. It's fun to meet fans all over the place and to play shows all over the place.
There's sometimes you go somewhere and you don't want to move, you're like, oh, no,
most of the time we wish we had longer in each city, you know, like, we flew in here last night and we're leaving here tonight, like,
yeah.
You know, like, that's just kind of, it's not always that bad, but we're pretty much all the time, we're on the move, so it sucks. Some of the places I wish we could visit longer, but it definitely is fun to, you know, usually around like the second or third time we come to a country or something, we'll really get to spend a little bit of time. So it's not so bad. It's good. It's fun.
It's amazing. You can say it.
Mm-hmm.
Few last questions. We're going to play a song from the Brand New Eyes. Which one do you want?
Again?
Yeah, it's three parts.
Well, seeing as
you choose everything.
We're about to play a song, so we won't play that one. How about we play, do you want to play a single or not a single?
What singles do we have so far? Do we put Brick on the radio yet?
Brick, you can choose whatever you want.
Do you not want to choose a single or you want to choose a single?
I don't mind either way.
Yeah, how about we play Playing God? Number three on our record.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, you have that song. But we're coming back to open up for Green Day.
Yeah,
we
know it's in June.
Okay, so it's in June.
She'll tell you.
June 26th. Was Green Day?
We'll be here
June
26th.
I'm about to say that.
We're playing some stadium, which is pretty crazy. We're really excited. And then other than that, I'm not sure when we come back for our own show, but I would imagine it won't be too long, because we love it here, so... We'll come back.
I think Green Day's opening up for us.
I think, yeah, the next time Green Day opens up.
Just kidding.
Thank you so much, Paramore.
Thank you, guys.
Can you say those sentences for me?
Sure.
Hi, it's Paramore. We're listening to Goom Radio, Goom Radio Justice, and Goom Radio Popcorn, and Goom Radio Rocket.
Popcorn?
Yes.
Then we have the
everything. I love popcorn. Popcorn is so good.
I have to step it in.
Hey,
we're
Brand New Eyes.
Hey, it was cool.
I was reading.
can read it wrong.
Okay, okay, so hey, we're pair one.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can change it if you want.
One, two.
Hey, we're Paramore, and you're listening to Goom Radio.
Do you just do all, should we do all those separately or all together again?
All together. All right. Okay, cool.
One,
two.
One, two.
Hey, we're Paramore, and you're listening to Goom Radio Just Hits.
One, two.
Hey, we're Paramore, you're listening to Goom Radio Popcorn. Yummy.
One, two.
Hey, we're Paramore, and you're listening to Goom Radio Rocket.
One, two, three.
All right.